Hearing that music, it sounds like something of a procession. Well, will this match be something of a procession, or will we see the greatest upset ever in darts? Well, one of them we'll find out with Chris Mason and Stuart Pike.
Well, what an opportunity for Rob Cross, the 26-year-old from Hastings in Sussex, the electrician who has made a big name for himself this weekend. The final, two Riley's qualifiers left. We're about to see Barry Lynn take on Gary Anderson over on board two. But here, Rob Cross, the stuff of darting dreams at the FA Cup of Darts here at Butlins in Minehead, against the man they all have to beat. Very impressive with those two 170 finishes against Ryan Harrington in the third round. And quite rightly, the favourite, the world number one, the number one seed here at the UK Open Finals for a fourth consecutive year. And it would be, well, it was 2 years ago, we remember, that Aidan Kirk beat Phil Taylor on this very stage at the UK Open, and that was one of the biggest upsets we've seen for a long, long time. But this would top that if somehow Cross can find a way. He has the darts, quite simply, one of the biggest days of Rob Cross's life.
Yep, he'll remember this one for a while. And if he managed to win, he'd never forget it. Well, he made a slow start in his game yesterday, didn't he?
Yeah.
21 darts, I think, the first leg.
Chatting to him after that game, said there was no disrespect to anybody that he played. Just sometimes he finds it difficult to get himself going, but he'll just want to dominate from the off.
When I land on 40.
Well, what he has achieved and what he continues to achieve, Michael van Gerwen, he's just a darting freak, isn't he?
Yeah, I didn't ever believe I'd see someone emulate Phil in terms of numbers, but this man somehow has eclipsed Phil in terms of big averages. As we've seen just a couple of weeks ago in the Premier League with that 1-2-3.4.
Double 16. Well, that was nearly 301 in six perfect darts. But an outside chance here for Cross. One treble gives him a shot at the bull. Yes, bullseye for Rob Cross in the opening leg. Oh, well, it hit the wire. It hit the wire. How unlucky. Well, Michael van Gerwen takes the opening leg. But a glimmer of a chance there for Rob Cross. Did well. Just to give you a result, by the way, coming in from ball three. And a real upset here, because Stuart Kellett has beaten Michael Smith 9-5. Smith was 3-1 up in that, so Smith is out. Kellett goes through.
Yeah, huge shock. Though they would know each other fairly well, and I'm sure he's had plenty of victories over Smith over the years. Probably not so many in recent times, but that's a big, big win for Kellett, who has really struggled the last few years, unlike this man.
Well, 180s in the opening two legs from the world number one.
Ominous.
96.
If you're Rob Cross, how do you approach this? Just enjoy it. You've got to, haven't you?
Yep.
Try and play with a smile on your face. And I mean, no one gives you a chance, but just go and enjoy it and see what happens, I guess. Win a leg and take it from there.
Yep, one leg at a time. One throw at a time.
60. Michael, you require 40.
For 2-0.
Game shown the second leg. Mark of Angle, third leg rock to throw first.
Well, needs to get. Sorry, Stuart.
I was going to say, yet again, Michael van Gerwen. He lost in the World Championship semi-final last year, didn't he, to Gary Anderson, and then went on to completely dominate the rest of the year, appearing in TV final after TV final. And
57.
I think losing at the World Championship this year to Raymond van Barneveld has made him angry again.
Green being the right colour.
60.
Cross, his wife Georgia, and children Leighton and Imogen will be watching on. And this game encapsulates what the UK Open is all about.
Yep, spot on. That's what I was about to say. Great opportunity to see. Brilliant.
Well, he's hit a 180. His big TV debut on the big stage against the best player in the world.
138.
Well, he went the 174 route to need 170. He hit two of them in his first game yesterday.
44.
Yeah, it's a great opportunity this event to see what's about to arrive on the scene.
Well, he had to, didn't he? 3 180s in the first three legs. You're not bothered about leaving double 13.
All the same size.
All the same to van Gerwen.
Oh, 20 for tops.
What a chance.
A bit awkward. That dart sat up. Needs to go left or right of that one.
Oh, magic. What a dart. He hit a 180 and took out 120.
And that's the reason he finds himself in this position.
Yeah, he's beaten Canada's Ken McNeil, 6-3. Big scalping, Wes Newton, 6-4. He's played beautifully here, yet again against Michael van Gerwen. How about that? 180 in consecutive legs. He's averaging 99, and he's forcing the world number one to be his very, very best. In the third round against Holland's Geoffrey de Graaf, he won 9-8 from 8-5 down, Chris.
Shows he's got bags of bottles.
The adrenaline will be pumping and he'll be fired up, that's for sure. Turbo, they call him. An electrician by trade.
Van Gerwen on 130 after 9 thrown. Will he have to go for it?
81.
No.
Why can we require 130?
Well, how about this, we're talking about big upsets. How about this? On board two, the world champion Gary 65. Anderson is playing the Riley's qualifier 65. Barry Lynn, and the latest score 3-0 to Barry Lynn as Michael van Gerwen looks at double four to make it 3-1. Gary Anderson 0, Barry Lynn 4. He's 4-0 up against Gary Anderson.
I wonder what the odds are. Odds were on that happening.
Well, that's amazing. We'll be checking in on that and we'll be catching up 60. On that, I'm sure.
A penny for Gary's thoughts. It's in again.
Oh, he's hit 3 180s in three legs. Just like Michael van Gerwen, we've had 6 180s in this match.
91.
He's giving it a real go, but
he is.
How about that? Stunning story developing over on board two.
What is big lead? Just another one, isn't it?
4 180s now for Michael van Gerwen. What a start from both players. Van Gerwen averaging 108.
Oh, another one of those.
Is
double
eight. Well, how unlucky. It was 61. In and it was out.
Michael, you require 170.
The other dart just took the impetus off the previous.
96. Rob, you require 75.
Well, treble 17, double 12 is the normal route. 17, 18 tops. For 3-2.
Against the world number one.
And that sip of water at the break would taste even sweeter.
35.
Lucky.
Michael, you require 74.
Treble 14. 20 for tops. Awkward, has to move.
Game show. Lovely
dart. And Michael Van Gerwen does take control. We've had 7 180s. A stunning start. Great performance from the qualifier, Rob Cross. But class will out. And class is Michael Van Gerwen, who leads 4-1 here at the UK Open Finals. Between the qualifier Barry Lynn and the world champion Gary Anderson. 4-1, Lynn in front. The other Riley's qualifier here is Rob Cross. He's 4-1 down, but he's played extremely well. He's taken out 120, he's hit 3 180s. And Michael Van Gerwen has been forced to play exceptionally well. And he is. He's about to hit his fifth 180, is he?
Had a leg. Over 15 darts in this one. Michael opened with a 15 and a 13, and as you mentioned, that great 120 checkout in his first 180 of the match. Cross went out in 15, and then Michael hit straight back. 15 and 15. All equates to a rather tidy 106.66 average.
Well, acquitted himself really well, Rob Cross. Guaranteed £3,000, playing the world number one on the big stage, living the dream.
Live on ITV4.
And he's won 9 matches to get to this stage already after coming through those Riley's qualifiers.
And you can see why. Tidy player.
Which way, Michael?
82.
Well, that's okay. To leave 56 after 12.
14 dart leg possibility. 16 27. Tops, I presume, will be his route. 56.
Game shot at 6 leg. Michael.
So 5-1 it is. And it is a procession at the moment for Michael Van Gerwen, as he looks to make it back-to-back UK Open crowns, defending his title here.
60.
It's now 5-2 to Barry Lynn against Gary Anderson on stage two. First to 9.
And that would be...
The qualifier needs 4 legs to beat the world champion.
It will be a huge shock.
Barry Lynn is having the day of his life. Gary Anderson is in all sorts of trouble. Michael Van Gerwen here is a man on a mission.
91. Rob, you require 160.
A darting dream. Well, Gary is having a nightmare.
104.
Well, he's got a chance here, really good chance to win a second leg cross.
Yeah, 57 after 12.
Might be
thrown.
Under pressure though.
135. Rob, you require 57.
17 tops then. A 14 dart leg of his own.
Well, he's had his chances.
Will he get another one? Unlikely.
Five out of eight on the doubles for Van Gerwen. Tops again.
35.
So Cross comes back with a chance to win a second one.
Robbie required 20. Game start
well
on the seventh leg. Rob Cross, eighth leg, Michael the through first.
Well, he's done well. He's played well. I know the sponsors were reporting
42.
Some heavy backing for 9-0 and 9-1. There's some betting slips been torn up, but well done to Rob Cross. He really has played well.
Well, no fluke that he's 43. Got to this stage. Like you say, this is nine matches in. I don't care who you are, it takes some doing.
59.
6-2 now to Lynn.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. It's what it's developing into one of the big stories. So we mentioned 2 years ago Aidan Kirk beating Phil Taylor.
And Peter Wright.
Yeah, and Peter Wright. But 6-2, Barry Lynn against Gary Anderson.
Three away.
55.
Here, Michael Van Gerwen is four away.
Big chance here for the cross.
Yeah, to get the darts.
Yeah. Oh, that was pulled badly.
Yeah, really good adjustment.
76.
Quitting himself really well.
140.
Needs to find a treble.
58.
Dear. Big chance now. Cross. 142. Has the throw. Just take a ton off. Oh dear.
41. Mark, we require 148.
Went 54-54 for tops.
43.
He's
mess
bored.
Of it.
He's bored.
Robbie require 101.
Well, can he break the Van Gerwen throw?
One
he might, you know.
Double 16. For 5-3. And a break of throw.
Oh, 101. 101, not in this room.
Game on.
Barry Lynn, 7-2 up on Gary Anderson. Absolutely incredible.
100.
Well, confirming that we're on the verge 58. Of one of the big shocks in the history of the UK Open. Jana Klassen just ahead against Joe Mernon. Rind of Reeders missed doubles. Mencius Sulevic leads 5-3.
It has to be the biggest one. I mean, I remember when Adrian Gray beat Phil Taylor in the Grand Prix, and that was a shock.
96.
Well, meanwhile, here,
96.
Rob Cross is fighting back. He's won two legs on the spin. Michael Van Gerwen here has been forced to play like that. Brilliant 177 to leave. Well, guess what?
His favourite finish.
97. Michael, you require 170.
Barry Lynn. Oh, boom.
And again. Oh, and again! Three, he says. Three indeed. Two 170 finishes against Ryan Harrington. And another one here. Amazing.
Even more amazing. Barry Lynn now leads Anderson 8-2. Well, he's had a 177, followed by that 170 finish.
Well, well done. 6-4. Van Gerwen, fourth across. Van Gerwen's on the darter. Van Gerwen They've just gone 177, 170 out, 180, 180. He's on a 9 darter. We haven't seen one here at the UK Open final since 2013.
Here we go.
Treble 19. He needs double 12 for a magical 9 darter at the UK Open.
Wow.
Magical, mighty Michael van Gerwen. Wow. Saturday afternoon at the UK Open at Michael van Gerwen. Lights the tungsten touch paper. Chris, 177 followed by a 170 out in the ninth leg, and he's just done a 1-4-1 for a 9-dart finish. And Michael van Gerwen with darts yet again to take your breath away. Don't go anywhere. Stunning entertainment here in Minehead. Van Gerwen leads 7-3. Fabulous! Well, here on board two, they've just come back after the second break. We've witnessed an astonishing 9-darter from Michael van Gerwen at the UK Open. And are we about to witness on board two one of the biggest upsets in the history of this tournament, going all the way back to 2003? Because Barry Lynn, the Riley's qualifier, leads Gary Anderson 8-2.
And has the throw, I think. Oh, maybe not.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for the game to play first game on.
Can you believe this? Gary Anderson can't. He was 3-0 down with two breaks of throw. And here, Barry Lynn. In the match of his life, Chris Mason.
Yeah, absolutely incredible.
98.
Just couldn't call this. And to be honest, he doesn't look fazed.
Well, can you believe this? Can you believe this?
Well, if he can somehow find a way 95. To get out of this one. Quite possibly.
Well, from what we've seen and what we've heard as well, Chris, it's thoroughly deserving to be in this position.
Yeah, it's not a case of Gary's been missing doubles. He's been outplayed.
100.
Well, Anderson, no one could have predicted this, Chris. Gary Anderson, who did really well to get past Dave Chisnall.
85, Gary, you require 108.
But here, Barry Lynn is closing in on, well, a famous, famous win. You're shaking your head in disbelief, Chris.
Yeah, I just didn't see this coming. He looked so comfortable, Gary. Oh, what a way to win it. This. Oof.
Well,
tops to rescue one more back.
Look, he's left double eight just in case. Anderson at tens, and Anderson saves face, wins one leg back, 8-3.
Now Lynn has the throw.
Well, drama on Saturday afternoon at the UK Open. And another 180 for Barry Lynn. Well, is this a dream? Pinch me, he'll be saying. Barry Lynn from Braintree in Essex. Live wire, they call him.
Never heard of him.
Absolutely incredible. Qualified
100
at South Benfleet in the Riley's qualifiers. And he's playing the double back-to-back 58. World champion, Gary Anderson. And he's closing in on something quite remarkable.
Living the darting dream.
43.
Well, nothing but a 180 now for Gary. Needs to fill it. And does.
Well, just to put some pressure on Lynn, he'll be thinking six darts from 178.
He's not phased, is he?
He just played brilliantly. The man with the Midas touch. It really has been. This is astonishing. Absolutely astonishing.
133.
Well, straight at it or split it. 6 double 16 or straight at it.
Well, he split it. 6 for 16 for the match to beat Gary Anderson.
Unbelievable.
Barry Lynn has beaten Gary Anderson in one of the biggest upsets in the history of the UK Open. The Rileys qualifier from Braintree in Essex has taken out the champion of the world. But he hasn't just beaten him. He has thrashed Anderson. 9-3, Lynn beats Gary Anderson. What an afternoon here. We've seen a 9-darter from Michael van Gerwen. And we've seen Barry Lynn beating Gary Anderson. And we'll be hearing from Lynn very shortly. He will be speaking to Ned Bolting.
Incredible story.
Well, the last 10 minutes. Game on. Astonishing, astonishing. Well, Michael van Gerwen there was watching the big screen in the arena here on the main stage.
Probably
watching what was unfolding.
Himself, that was handy.
Well, Michael van Gerwen.
Well, look at this. Nine.
Let me tell you this. What? Let me tell you this. His last six visits, 177, 170 out, 180, 180, 141 and 177. And now another 180 for Cross. This is astonishing. Well, the last 15 minutes is why we love this sport. Well, absolutely incredible.
The only time
incredible.
I can remember Michael doing similar is when he nearly hit the back-to-back 9-darters.
Against James Wade at the World Championship. He missed double 12.
Double 12.
For back-to-back 9-darters. We've seen a 9-darter. The UK Open for the first time since 2013 when Wes Newton did one against Adrian Lewis. Phil Taylor's hit four at the UK Open Finals. Mervyn King's hit one. Gary Anderson, Wes Newton and now Michael van Gerwen in 2016.
Fortunate there.
And look what he's left. Could have bust. Look what he's left to try and win it.
Just for fun.
Oh, he can't, can he? He can't, can he? Of course he can! It's a second 117 each, one leg now to make it through to the fifth round. He hit two 170 finishes against Ryan Harrington. He's hit two now against Rob Cross. He's flying with 107 average. And we have witnessed in the last 10 minutes something extra, extra special. As Rob Cross
take about
into
Rob.
Sixth 180. Michael van Gerwen trying to hit an eighth.
Ridiculous.
I think you and I'll have to go for a lie down.
Yeah. Or a large brandy. Unbelievable darts. My goodness.
Well. 93. Sometimes it's just a pleasure and a privilege to witness
a sequence of throws.
A huge story. Barry Lynn beating Gary Anderson. Michael van Gerwen has hit a 9-dart finish and two 170 finishes. And this, well, he went double-double for 54. The match. But he does need this leg to win it.
Well, whatever happens, Rob Cross will never forget his experience of the UK Open. 11 dart leg. Superb. Shocks, surprises, and the spectacular. Unbelievable day. We're only halfway through the tournament.
Right, I've had my lie down.
43.
Astonishing. Astonishing. Oh, he's enjoying himself, isn't he? he will have been inspired as well, I'm sure, by watching Barry Lynn beat Gary Anderson. If you are just joining us, what a story.
Well, Cross is at 6180s, 5140s. He's averaging 96.5.
He's broken Van Gerwen twice. If you are just joining us, you've missed a Michael Van Gerwen 9 darter, plus separately 2 170 finishes from the world number one.
That's 4 170 finishes in two games.
You've also missed one of the biggest stories in the history of this tournament. Barry Lynn from Essex, a Riley's qualifier, has thrashed the world champion Gary Anderson by 9-3. Wow, just because he can, he leaves double two for the match and hits a ninth. 180, Cross to stay in it. Which way has he gone? Well, he was looking for 18, but he's left the ball. He hit a single four, 20.
25. He went for 54, double 10, I think. Double two.
Double one, that's a good guide. Oh! Three match darts missed by Michael Van Gerwen.
All right, so the nine tops are 17, double 16.
Well, those three misses take Van Gerwen's average down to just below 107.
Average.
average for him. Oh, and another leg! Back-to-back legs for young Rob Cross. 93. Michael Van Gerwen's missed three match darts. He still needs one more leg to beat the Riley's qualifier. Well, seldom at this tournament, which started back in 2003, can I remember a 10 minutes like this. He isn't finished yet, is he? He's hit seven in all and four in the last four legs. 16 180s in this match.
In 13 and a smidge legs. 42. That could be the end.
Oh, breathtaking stuff, Chris Mason.
Yeah. 34. Like you said, the sequence of darts was just unbelievable.
And you've had a nine darter.
Yes.
95. Michael, you require 134.
Well, another
double 16, yeah,
to leave the double.
Yes. 98.
Leaves 36.
46.
So, for Michael the match, Michael Van Gerwen. And there it is, to round off a terrific victory. 107 average. Michael Van Gerwen does grow through. But how about that from Rob Cross? He pushed him all the way with 7 180s. An amazing afternoon of darts. We see Michael Van Gerwen hit a 170 finish twice and a 9 darter at the UK Open. Van Gerwen is through. We'll be hearing from both players very shortly. Van Gerwen, 9 dart hero, wins 9-5.
Yeah, it's a great opportunity, this event, to see what's about to arrive on the scene.
Well, he had to, didn't he? 3 180s in the first three legs. You're not bothered about leaving double 13.
All the same size.
All the same to Van Gerwen.
Oh, 20 for tops.
What a chance.
A bit awkward, that dart sat up. Needs to go left or right of that one.
Oh, what a dart! He hit a 180 and took out 120.
And that's the reason he finds himself in this position.
Yeah, he's beaten Canada's Ken McNeil, 6-3. Big scalp in Wes Newton, 6-4. He's played beautifully here, yet again against Michael van Gerwen. How about that? 180 in consecutive legs. He's averaging 99. And he's forcing the world number one to be his very, very best. In the third round against Holland's Jeffrey de Graaf, he won 9-8 from 8-5 down, Chris.
Shows he's got bags of bottle.
The adrenaline will be pumping and he'll be fired up, that's for sure. Turbo, they call him. An electrician by trade.
Gerwen on 130 after 9 thrown. Will he have to go for it?
81. No. Why can we require 130?
Well, how about this? How about this? We're talking about big upsets. How about this? On board two, the world champion, Gary 65. Anderson, is playing the Rileys qualifier, Barry Lynn. And the latest score, 3-0 to Barry Lynn, as Michael van Gerwen looks at double four to make it 3-1. Gary Anderson 0, Barry Lynn 4. He's 4-0 up against Gary Anderson.
I wonder what the odds are. Odds were on that happening.
Well, that's amazing. We'll be checking in on that, and we'll be catching up 60. On that, I'm sure.
Penny for Gary's thoughts. It's in again.
Oh, he's hit 3 1/8. He's in three legs. Just like Michael van Gerwen, we've had 6 1/8s in this match.
91.
He's giving it a real go, but...
He is.
How about that? Stunning story developing over on board two.
What is big lead? Just another one, isn't it?
4 180s now for Michael van Gerwen. What a start from both players. Van Gerwen averaging 108.
Oh, another one of those for double eight.
Well, how unlucky. It was 61. In and it was out.
Michael, you require 170.
The other dart just took the impetus off the previous.
96. Rob, you require
75. Well, treble 17, double 12 is the normal route. 17, 18 tops. For 3-2
against the world number one.
And that sip of water at the break would taste even sweeter.
35.
Lucky.
Michael, you require 74.
Treble 14. 20 for tops. Awkward, has to move.
Game show.
Lovely dart. And Michael van Gerwen does take control. We've had 7 180s, a stunning start. Great performance from the qualifier, Rob Cross. But class will out. And class is Michael van Gerwen, who leads 4-1 here at the UK Open Finals. Between the qualifier, Barry Lynn, and the world champion, Gary Anderson. 4-1, Lynn in front. The other Rileys qualifier here is Rob Cross. He's 4-1 down, but he's played extremely well. He's taken out 120, he's hit 3 180s. And Michael van Gerwen, he's been forced to play exceptionally well. And he is. He's about to hit his fifth 180, is he?
Had a leg, over 15 darts in this one. Michael opened with a 15 and a 13, and as you mentioned, that great 120 checkout in his first 180 of the match. Cross went out in 15, and then Michael hit straight back.
15 and 15.
All equates to a rather tidy 106.66 average.
Well, acquitted himself really well, Rob Cross. Guaranteed £3,000, playing the world number one on the big stage, living the dream.
Live on ITV4.
And he's won.
Hearing that music, it sounds like something of a procession. Well, will this match be something of a procession? Or will we see the greatest upset ever in darts? Well, one of them we'll find out with Chris Mason and Stuart Pike.
Well, what an opportunity for Rob Cross, the 26-year-old from Hastings in Sussex, the electrician who has made a big name for himself this weekend. The final, two Riley's qualifiers left. We're about to see Barry Lynn take on Gary Anderson over on board two. But here, Rob Cross, the stuff of darting dreams at the FA Cup of Darts here at Butlins in Minehead, against the man they all have to be. Very impressive with those two 170 finishes against Ryan Harrington in the third round. And quite rightly the favourite, the world number one, the number one seed here at the UK Open Finals for a fourth consecutive year. And it would be, well, it was 2 years ago, we remember, that Aidan Kirk beat Phil Taylor on this very stage at the UK Open, and that was one of the biggest upsets we've seen for a long, long time. But this would top that if somehow Cross can find a way. He has the darts, quite simply, one of the biggest days of Rob Cross's life.
Yep, you remember this one for a while. And if he managed to win, he'd never forget it. Well, he made a slow start in his game yesterday, didn't he?
Yeah.
21 darts, I think, the first leg.
Chatted to him after that game, said there was no disrespect to anybody that he played. Just sometimes he finds it difficult to get himself going, but he'll just want to dominate from the off. Well, with what he has achieved and what he continues to achieve, Michael van Gerwen, he's just a darting freak, isn't he?
Yeah, I didn't ever believe I'd see someone emulate Phil in terms of numbers, but this man somehow has eclipsed Phil in terms of big averages. As we've seen just a couple of weeks ago in the Premier League with that 123.4.
Double 16. Well, that was nearly 301 in six perfect darts. But an outside chance here for Cross. One treble gives him a shot at the bull. Yes, bullseye for Rob Cross in the opening leg. Oh, well, it hit the wire. It hit the wire. How unlucky. Well, Michael van Gerwen takes the opening leg. But was a glimmer of a chance there for Rob Cross. Did well. Just to give you a result, by the way, coming in from ball three. And a real upset here because Stuart Kellett has beaten Michael Smith 9-5. Smith was 3-1 up in that, so Smith is out. Kellett goes through.
Yeah, huge shock. Though they would know each other fairly well, and I'm sure he's had plenty of victories over Smith over the years. Probably not so many in recent times, but that's a big, big win for Kellett, who has really struggled the last few years. Unlike this man.
Well, 180s in the opening two legs from the world number one.
Ominous.
96.
If you're Rob Cross, how do you approach this? Just enjoy it. You've got to, haven't you?
Yep.
Try and play with a smile on your face.
One
and I mean, no one gives you a chance, but just go and enjoy it and see what happens, I guess. Win a leg and take it from there.
Yep, one leg at a time. One throw at a time.
60. Michael, you require 40.
For 2-0.
Game shown the second leg. Mark of Angle. Third leg rock to throw first.
Well, needs to get. Sorry, Stu.
I was going to say, yet again, Michael van Gerwen. He lost in the World Championship semi-final last year, didn't he? To Gary Anderson, and then went on to completely dominate the rest of the year, appearing in TV final after TV final. And
57.
I think losing at the World Championship this year to Raymond van Barneveld has made him angry again.
Green being the light colour.
60.
Cross, his wife Georgia, and children Leighton and Imogen will be watching on. This game encapsulates what the UK Open is all about.
Yep, spot on. That's what I was about to say. Great opportunity to see. Brilliant.
Well, he's hit a 180. His big TV debut on the big stage against the best player in the world.
38.
Well, he went the 174 route to need 170. He hit two of them in his first game yesterday. 80 now for Gary. Needs to fill it. And does.
180.
Just to put some pressure on Lynn, he'll be thinking six darts from 178.
He's not phased, is he?
He just played brilliantly. The man with the Midas touch. It really has been. This is astonishing. Absolutely astonishing.
133.
Well, straight at it or split it. 6 double 16 or straight at it.
Well, he split it. 6 for 16 for the match to beat Gary Anderson.
Unbelievable.
Barry Lynn has beaten Gary Anderson in one of the biggest upsets in the history of the UK Open. The Rileys qualifier from Braintree in Essex has taken out the champion of the world. But he hasn't just beaten him. He has thrashed Anderson. 9-3, Lynn beats Gary Anderson. What an afternoon here. We've seen a 9-darter from Michael van Gerwen. And we've seen Barry Lynn beating Gary Anderson. And we'll be hearing from Lynn very shortly. He will be speaking to Ned Bolting.
Incredible story.
Well, the last 10 minutes.
Game on.
Astonishing. Astonishing. Well, Michael van Gerwen there was watching the big screen in the arena here on the main stage.
Probably
watching what was unfolding.
That was handy.
Well, Michael van Gerwen.
Well, look at
this. Let me tell you this. What? Let me tell you this. His last six visits, 177, 170 out, 180, 180, 141 and 177. And now another 180 for Cross. This is astonishing. Well, the last 15 minutes is why we love this sport. Well, absolutely
incredible. The only time
incredible.
I can remember Michael doing similar is when he nearly hit the back-to-back 9-darters.
Against James Wade at the World Championship. He missed double 12.
Double 12.
60. For back-to-back 9-darters. We've seen a 9-darter. The UK Open for the first time since 2013 when Wes Newton did one against Adrian Lewis. Phil Taylor's hit four at the UK Open Finals. Mervyn King's hit one. Gary Anderson, Wes Newton and now Michael van Gerwen in 2016.
Fortunate there. You
and look what he's left.
Could have bust.
Look what he's left to try and win it.
Just for fun.
Oh, he can't, can he? He can't, can he? Of course he can! Michael van Gerwen, it's a second 117 each, one leg now to make it through to the fifth round. He hit two 170 finishes against Ryan Harrington. He's hit two now against Rob Cross. He's flying with 107 average. And we have witnessed in the last 10 minutes something extra, extra special. As Rob Cross
take about
hits
Rob.
A sixth 180. Michael van Gerwen trying to hit an eighth.
Wow. Ridiculous.
I think you and I'll have to go for a lie down.
Yeah. Or a large brandy. Unbelievable darts. My goodness.
Well. 93. Sometimes it's just a pleasure and a privilege to witness
a sequence of throws.
A huge story. Barry Lynn beating Gary Anderson. Michael van Gerwen has hit a 9-dart finish and two 170 finishes. And this, well, he went double-double for the match, but he does need this leg to win it.
Well, whatever happens, Rob Cross will never forget his experience of the UK Open. 11-dart leg. Superb. Shocks, surprises, and the spectacular. Unbelievable day. We're only halfway through the tournament.
Right, I've had me lie down.
43.
Astonishing. Astonishing. Oh, he's enjoying himself, isn't he? He will have been inspired as well, I'm sure, by watching Barry Lynn beat Gary Anderson. If you are just joining us, what a story.
Well, Cross is at 6-180s, 5-140s. He's averaging 96 and a half.
He's broken van Gerwen twice. If you are just joining us, you've missed a Michael van Gerwen 9-darter, plus separately two 170 finishes from the world number one.
Which that's four 170 finishes in two games.
You've also missed one of the biggest stories in the history of this tournament. Barry Lynn from Essex, a Riley's qualifier, has thrashed the world champion Gary Anderson by 9-3. Wow, just because he can, he leaves double two for the match and hits a ninth. 180, Cross to stay in it. Well, meanwhile, here, 90. Rob Cross is fighting back. He's won two legs on the spin. Michael van Gerwen here has been forced to play like that. Brilliant 177 to leave. Well, guess what?
His favourite finish.
97. Michael, you require 170.
Barry Lynn. Oh, boom.
And again. Oh, and again! Three, he says. Three indeed. Two 170 finishes against Ryan Harrington. And another one here. Amazing.
Even more amazing. Barry Lynn now leads Anderson 8-2. Well, he's had a 177, followed by that 170 finish.
Well, well done. 6-4, van Gerwen. 4 for Cross. Van Gerwen's on the 9-darter. Van Gerwen has just gone 177, 170 out, 180, 180. He's on a 9-darter. We haven't seen one here at the UK Open Finals since 2013.
Here we go.
Treble 19. He needs double 12 for a magical 9-darter at the UK Open.
Wow.
Magical, mighty Michael van Gerwen. Wow. Saturday afternoon at the UK Open. and Michael van Gerwen lights the tungsten touch paper. Chris, 177 followed by a 170 out in the ninth leg, and he's just done a 1-4-1 for a 9-dart finish. And Michael van Gerwen with darts yet again to take your breath away. Don't go anywhere. Stunning entertainment here in Minehead. Van Gerwen leads 7-3. Fabulous! Well, here on board two, they've just come back after the second break. We've witnessed an astonishing 9-darter from Michael van Gerwen at the UK Open. And are we about to witness on board two one of the biggest upsets in the history of this tournament, going all the way back to 2003? Because Barry Lynn, the Riley's qualifier, leads Gary Anderson 8-2.
And has the throw, I think. Oh, maybe not.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, for going to the first game on.
Can you believe this? Gary Anderson can't. He was 3-0 down with two breaks of throw. And here, Barry Lynn. In the match of his life, Chris Mason.
Yeah, absolutely incredible.
98.
Just couldn't call this. And to be honest, he doesn't look fazed.
Well, can you believe this? Can you believe this?
Well, if he can somehow find a way 95. To get out of this one, quite possibly.
Well, from what we've seen and what we've heard as well, Chris, it's thoroughly deserving to be in this position.
Yeah, it's not a case of Gary's been missing doubles. He's been outplayed.
100.
Well, Anderson, no one could have predicted this, Chris. Gary Anderson, who did really well to get past Dave Chisnall.
85. Gary, you require 108.
But here, Barry Lynn is closing in on, well, famous win. You're shaking your head in disbelief, Chris.
Yeah, I just didn't see this coming. He looked so comfortable, Gary. Oh, what a way to win it.
Well,
tops to rescue one more back.
Look, he's left double eight just in case. Anderson at tens, and Anderson saves face, wins one leg back, 8-3.
Now Lynn has the throw.
Well, drama on Saturday afternoon at the UK Open. And another 180 for Barry Lynn. Well, is this a dream? Pinch me, he'll be saying. Barry Lynn from Braintree in Essex. Livewire, they call him.
Never heard of him.
Absolutely incredible. Qualified
100
at South Benfleet in the Riley's qualifiers. And he's playing the double back-to-back 58. World champion, Gary Anderson. And he's closing in on something quite remarkable.
Living the darting dream.
43.
Well, nothing but a 1-8.
9 matches to get to this stage already after coming through those Riley's qualifiers.
And you can see why. Tidy player.
Which way, Michael?
82.
Well, that's okay. To leave 56 after 12.
14 dart leg possibility. 16 tops, I presume, will be his route. 56.
Game shown the sixth leg.
Michael. So 5-1 it is.
First.
It is a procession at the moment for Michael van Gerwen as he looks to make it back-to-back UK Open crowns, defending his title here.
60.
It's now 5-2 to Barry Lynn against Gary Anderson on stage two. First and nine.
Wow. That would be...
A qualifier needs four legs to beat the world champion.
It will be a huge shock.
Barry Lynn is having the day of his life. Gary Anderson is in all sorts of trouble. Michael van Gerwen here is a man on a mission.
91. Rob, you require 161.
A darting dream. Well, Gary is having a nightmare.
104.
He's got a chance here, really good chance to win a second leg cross.
Yeah, 57 after 12.
Might be
thrown
under pressure though.
135. What do you require? 57.
17 tops them. For a 14 dart leg of his own.
Well, he's had his chances.
Yep. Will he get another one? Unlikely.
Five out of eight on the doubles for van Gerwen. Tops again.
35.
So cross comes back.
He misses
with a chance
one
to win a second one.
Robbie required 20. Game shot on the seventh leg. Drop cross, eighth leg, Michael the through first.
Well, he's done well. He's played well. I know the sponsors were reporting
42.
Some heavy backing for 9-0 and 9-1. There's some betting slips been torn up, but well done to Rob Cross. He really has played well.
Well, no fluke that he's 43. Got to this stage. You say this is nine matches in. I don't care who you are, it takes some doing.
59.
6-2 now to Lynn.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. It's developing into one of the big stories. So we mentioned 2 years ago Aidan Kirk beating Phil Taylor.
And Peter Wright.
Yeah, and Peter Wright. But 6-2, Barry Lynn against Gary Anderson.
Three away.
55.
Here, Michael van Gerwen is four away.
Big chance here for Cross.
Yeah, to get the darts.
Yeah. Oh, that was pulled back then.
Yeah, really good adjustment.
76.
Quitted himself really well.
140.
Needs to find a treble.
58.
Dear. Big chance now. Cross. 142. Has the throw. Just take a ton off. Oh dear.
41. Mark, we require 148.
Went 54-54 for tops.
43.
Made a mess
bored
of it.
He's bored.
Probably require 101.
Well, can he break the van Gerwen throw?
One
he might, you
nine
know.
Double 16. The 5-3. And a break of throw.
Oh, 101. 101, not in this room.
Game on.
Barry Lynn, 7-2 up on Gary Anderson. Absolutely incredible.
100.
Well, confirming that we're on the verge 58. Of one of the big shocks in the history of the UK Open. Jana Klassen just ahead against Joe Mernon. Ryan de Vrede has missed doubles. Mensur Suljovic leads 5-3.
Wow. That's really the biggest one. I mean, I remember when Adrian Gray beat Phil Taylor in the Grand Prix, and that was a shock.
96. Yep.